concluding remarks, which of course are Lutz's concluding remarks as well. So apologies to those of you who've sent in questions, but I think we should just move to the concluding remarks looking at the time. And it's very apt that we hand over to Lutz for the concluding remarks, of course, because as I said, he's been the key behind this whole conference. And I felt very guilty today. Every time that someone says thank you very much and mentions my name, I should say that over the last few weeks, of course, well, over all the weeks organizing this, it's been Lutz that's been the driving force between this behind this. And of course, he's been replying to everyone with their emails and everything else whilst he's doing everything else. So thank you very much to everyone who's been involved. I'll just say very quickly, thank you very much, of course, to our admin colleagues. I'll just mention that as well. And in particular, Bonnie, who's been liaising with all of you as well, and everyone who's been participating. The numbers have been steady, at times over 150, 120 at present. So I think that's quite good. I don't know why Lutz was ever worried about people coming to an unjust enrichment conference. But now I will hand over to the man himself, to our Dean, Professor Lutz-Christian Wolff, to give us our concluding remarks.
Thank you very much, Steve. I promise I will not be as radical as I was in my presentation. We actually had a great day, a very long, a very intense day. It started with Professor Martinet's brilliant overview and his compelling reasons why every jurisdiction needs an unjust enrichment system. He sends his apologies. He had to leave for a private matter. Then my colleague and friend and brother-in-arms in organizing this conference, Professor Gallagher, explored unjust enrichment from the viewpoint of equity. And I heard a bit of skepticism there as to the role of the law of unjust enrichment, probably because he thinks it will bite into his area, equity law. But there we go. Then we had Dr. Ludman, who informed us in her comparative survey of the measure of liability in unjust enrichment cases. And she adopted a comparative approach to underscore conclusions, which reminded us how important comparative law really is in a globalized world. After the first panel with general topics, we then started with Professor Hara's excellent analysis of the role of the law of unjust enrichment in Japan. Of course, Professor Hara brings to the table, to our attention, the specifics of civil law, in particular, the latest development in Japan. We were able to get a first-hand introduction to the latest reforms. Thank you for that. Then Professor Liu Chao honored us with his very sharp observations regarding developments in China. In fact, in particular, the importance of Chinese courts in the development of unjust enrichment law. And this has reminded us that the law of unjust enrichment is often discussed by academics, but eventually the practical aspects are shaped by the courts. The next speaker was Dr. Lin Siyi, who took a very unique view, and she gave us again a very detailed introduction to the latest developments, but she also explained why unjust enrichment law, contrary to what Professor Martinek and many others here have said, why the law of unjust enrichment is not probably always a must. There are other tools with which the law can carry out that mechanical function that Professor Martinek has described so brilliantly. The second panel concluded with the presentation of Professor Ramasawai about the role of unjust enrichment in Macau. Macanese law is, of course, basically Portuguese law, but Macau is also part of China. And from this perspective, Professor Ramavami's remark about the importance of comparative studies, again, seemed to be particularly important. The third panel then started with Professor Kaur's very interesting review of unjust enrichment law in India. And I'm still not sure whether it was rather, whether India rather adheres to the general concept of restitution rather than having a specific unjust enrichment law. Professor Tang Hangwu, another very accomplished scholar in the area of unjust enrichment, then explored the role of the law of unjust enrichment in Singapore. another common law jurisdiction, followed by Mr. Arthur Lee's brilliant analysis of the situation in Hong Kong. It was a real eye-opener for me to compare these three common law jurisdictions in Asia and see how they have deviated from the motherland, from English law. The last presentation of this panel, Ms. Lee, Lin Chi Na, took us back to Macau and showed, in particular, I was impressed by the secondary role or the supplementary role of the law of unjust enrichment in Macau as it was imported from Portugal. And then, of course, the last panel, Ms. Kati Lam, her very engaging presentation on the law of unjust enrichment in Malaysia, combining English law with the specifics of Malaysia, Indian law at the time. And it made me very proud to see one of our JD students to make such a high quality presentation at such a high quality panel conference. Now, finally, there was, of course, me with my Rambo-like remarks at the end, and I have to apologize for having potentially rocked the boat a little bit too much, but I thought that was necessary to wake all of us up at the very end of such a long day. Again, I wish to thank all the speakers for excellent presentations, all the participants for joining, and everybody else, everybody for the good discussions. Colleagues, many thanks for chairing the panels. A big vote of thanks to our admin colleagues who have made this conference such a smooth sailing. Special thanks, of course, as always, to Bonnie for keeping us all on our toes and for ensuring that everything has worked out well. I sincerely hope that this conference will only be the start of our discussions, of our collaborations, our work, our research work on the law of unjust enrichment and the law of obligations in general. We hope that you will join the CUHK Law Obligations Lab Asia in order to move these things forward. Normally, at this point, I would have thanked you again, and then we would have all gone for a great dinner with lots of wine, of course. But COVID-19 doesn't allow this, so this conference, unfortunately, has to come to an end at this point. Many thanks again to everybody for joining and all your contributions. We are CUHK Law. We all are. Let's stay in touch. Bye-bye.